Good morning students. Today also I will continue with the factorization chapter of your algebra section from your second unit test syllabus, and today also we will focus on the sums of exercise 16. So please follow the sums. Today we will start with sum number 10 of exercise 16. Now this exercise 16 contains variety of sums, and among those we are going to solve the major sums. In sum number 10, it is given that x in bracket, outside the bracket and inside bracket x, x plus y plus z plus y, x plus y plus z. This is given in sum number 10. You have to solve this sum. As you can see that in both the expressions, the common factor is the bracket itself. The bracket containing x plus y plus z is present in both the terms. So here, this is also common, this is also common. So the common factor first we will take outside the bracket, x plus y plus z. And inside the second bracket, we will give another second bracket, and inside the second bracket, whatever is left in these two terms, that only we will write. In the first term, the leftover portion is only x, whereas in the second term, the second expression, the leftover portion after deducting x plus y plus z, the leftover portion is y. So x plus y we will write as a factor. So this is only the answer of the sum, x plus y plus z, and then x plus y. X plus y plus z in one bracket and x plus y in another bracket. You can keep this in second bracket or in first bracket as you wish, but this is the answer, x plus y plus z into x plus y, and both you will show in individual brackets. Now very quickly we will move on to a very different sum, that is sum number 11 and sum number 12. Let's see how to solve sum number 11. In sum number 11, it is given that x minus 1 whole square, x minus 1, this is sum number 11 that we are solving, whole square minus 2 into x minus 1 into y plus 1 plus y plus 1 whole square. How we will solve this sum? Here, first we will assume the first term as A, that is x minus 1 as A, and the last term, that is y plus 1 as B. This is A and this is B. Then obviously 2 into x minus 1 into y plus 1 will become 2 into A into B, assuming A minus x minus 1 as A and y plus 1 as b. So let us assume first. Let us assume x minus y as a and y plus 1 as b. So this we have assumed. Then the sum becomes, then the expression becomes, then the expression becomes this is a. So a square minus 2 into a into b plus b square. Now this is what? This is simply the formula of a minus b whole square. This is nothing but the formula of a minus b whole square. So we will write a minus b whole square. Now putting the value of a and b, putting the value of a and b, we get, we will put the value of a and b, and then we will get, what we will get in place of x, a, we will write x minus 1, and replacing b, we will write, a means x minus 1,
and b means a minus b, minus we will write over here, and b means y plus 1. Both these we will keep in a bracket and then give a square.
A minus b whole square, a means x minus 1 and b means y plus 1. So first we will keep this in the bracket. Why we are keeping this in bracket? Because on removing the bracket, the sign of y plus 1 will change. The sign of y plus 1 will change and it will become x minus 1 minus y plus 1 whole square. X minus 1 minus y and minus into plus 1 will become minus 1. So x minus 1 minus y minus 1, the sign has automatically changed. I am writing it over here. The last line again I am writing here. The last line becomes x minus 1 minus y minus 1. Why? Because on removing the bracket, the sign of both y and 1 changes. Sign gets multiplied and it becomes negative. So ultimately what is becoming? X minus y minus 2 whole square. So ultimately we are getting the answer as x minus y minus 1 and minus gives you minus 2 whole square. So this is what you will write and this is how you will end the sum. Here in this step the sum ends and this is the answer. Up till this you can do and you can leave the sum.
Understood. I hope you have understood. Now we will do the next sum, that is sum number 12. Sum number 12 also we will apply the same formula and same way, same method we will follow. We will assume something as A and then solve the sum. Let's see how to solve sum number 12. In sum number 12 it is given that x plus 5 whole square plus 4 into x plus 5 into plus 4. This is given in sum number 12. How you will solve? Let us assume same process, same method, just that we have followed in sum number 11. That only method we will follow here also by assuming x plus 5 as a, and then the sum becomes a square plus 4a plus 4. That means a square plus 2 into a into 2 plus 2 square. 4 means 2 square and this 4 is acting as a b. So here 2 into a into b means 2 into a into 2. That is, if you multiply this, you will get the previous step 4a. So this is just the formula of a plus 2 whole square. This is the formula of a plus 2 whole square. Now putting again a equals to x plus 5. Now we will replace a with the actual value of a. Now the actual value of this a is, this actual value of this a is x plus 5 plus 2 whole square. 2 we will write as it is. So now it becomes x plus 7 whole square. So this is the answer of the sum. X plus 7 whole square. You will leave the answer over here. You may solve it further also, but if you solve it up till this, you will get full marks. You may solve further this also. If you want to solve, you can solve this into the further step. That is, if you solve x plus 7 whole square, then you will get x square plus 2 into x into 7, that is 14x plus 49. This can be the answer or you can leave the answer up till this. In both the cases, you will get full marks. The answer you can leave up till this also, x plus 7 whole square, or you can break it even also, x square plus 14x plus 49.
That is applying the formula of a plus b whole square. Both are acceptable. Both are acceptable. You will get full marks. So I hope whatever I have explained, you have understood. In my next class, I will come up with variety of more sums from exercise 16. So till then, practice these sums well. Goodbye.